Millions of readers have been helped by the famous Babylonian parables, hailed as the greatest of all inspirational works on the subject of thrift, financial planning, and personal wealth. The Richest Man in Babylon, read it, recommend it, and get on the road to riches. Hello, my name is Neville Solomon, and this week's book is George Clason's The Richest Man in Babylon. Hello and God bless. I am Neville Solomon and welcome to another book review. I love books. I have over 5,000 books myself. People oftentimes ask me, how many books have you read? I've read at least 4,000 in terms of reading from cover to cover from beginning to end. I read over 1,000 books and I'm working on 1,000 more books. As I said, I had 5,000 books, so I have 1,000 more books to read. Well, the book I'm going to be reviewing this week is called The Richest Man in Babylon. The Richest Man in Babylon. It's a little small book. It's not too long. It's written by George Clason. It has over 144 pages long, so it's a nice little book, great to read. I am actually contemplating on giving this to young people, just in general to read, because this is an amazing book. I'm not going to spend too much time this week as it relates to the content of the book. I just wanted to inspire you to read and to get out there and to get the best books they can get your hands on. The Richest Man in Babylon is actually one of the best books that I've read. It's a very short read. It gives you seven simple steps as it relates to creating wealth, or at least controlling your money. Because the main concept behind the book is that you need to take control of your money. You're like an employer and your money is your employee. I'm just gonna share one of the principles in the book that really, really helped me. There's this concept in the church called tithing. So churches, many churches are ran by the free will giving of people in the church. So people will take at least 1/10 of their income and they'll invest it in helping their church and the purpose of their church. The Richest Man in Babylon takes this particular concept and says that you need to do the same thing for yourself. So we get our visa bill, we get our rent or our mortgage, we get our car payments, our insurance payments and so forth. And what we do each month is that we set aside money to pay these bills. So the Richest Man in Babylon, one of the first principles that he shares is that you need to set aside your own bill called the bill for the self. So before you pay your mortgage, your rent or anything else, you take 10% of what you've earned and you actually put it in a savings account for yourself. So the first bill that you pay is a bill to yourself. So many people, they're living on Visa. They're asking friends, you know, can I borrow money until my next paycheck? Why don't you actually just build up a savings so if you ever have to borrow money, you can borrow it from yourself? So the principle is that the first 10% of your finances, or if you are going to be putting your tithe into the church, the second 10% of your finances is to be put into a savings account that you do not touch. So you put away 10% of your savings, 10% of your pay into a savings that you do not touch, and you leave that there and you allow it to grow until it comes to a certain amount. Some people, they have like a goal of $1,000, $5,000, but once it hits about $5,000, then you move into a second principle. And the second principle is where you begin to think about investment. I'm not going to talk about that too much today, but I'm just going to encourage you to read this book and go through the seven principles of how to control your money. If you have any questions or any comments that you want to share, feel free to message me or to make a comment on this particular video and can have a discussion. I think it's very important that when it comes to finances, that you begin to really, really think about your future, not just retirement, but think about your future goals, think about the kind of life that you want to live. And I think that just investing in reading, investing in growing personally will help you in the long run. I know money is not everything, and this book is, I think, is a little bit more than about money, but it does focus on that. Money's not everything, but money is important. So it's important to invest some time as it relates to mastering money, but also it's important to invest time every day in reading and growing, expanding yourself, because the more that you can challenge yourself to grow, the better life you'll live. So once again, I'm Neville Solomon, and thank you for another book review. Let me know what you think about this book. Hopefully, for those of you who haven't read it, if you can just read it, it wouldn't take too long, 144 pages, maybe a week or less, you can read that. Get back to me, let me know what you think about the book. And for those of you who have read the book, just put some comments below and let others know your experience in just reading The Richest Man in Babylon. So George S. Clason is an amazing writer. He writes it in storybook form. That's what I said, I think is very helpful for youth as a young person can just read it. It's almost like watching a movie. Well, anyways, my name is Neville Solomon, and thank you for another book review.